Hello again, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another walk. This one, we're in the little village of Englefield Green, which comes under the borough of Runnymede. And Runnymede is in the county of Surrey. So it's a little small village, quite near to Staines and Egham, which is another one we will be doing. We've already done a walk in Staines. This one, I've often come through this little village. I thought, you know, next time I'm passing, we should stop off and have a little walk, which is what we're doing. So, Laleham Green, Borough of Runnymede, or Runnymede Borough Council, as you can see there. Now, we've got a nice little church here, cemetery, if that's the right word. But it's quite a small village, so we're going to have a little look. We'll have a look around through by the church. We'll have a look in here, actually. Structures here, 29, not sure what the date is, 1852, not quite sure the dates, 1862 is it? But you've got the old lime mortar there, known as tuck point in this here, with this little white ribbon. The reason they did that was when the bricks deteriorated, they filled it in with what they called a stopper to make the brick look full and then put the white on it, so when you stood back it would give the appearance of being a full brick, as you can see here. Not used so often nowadays, but when it is used to effect, it does bring out the building. You get it in a lot of period properties. So if you stand back here, you can see it. It just looks like they're full bricks, whereas in fact they're really old and quite worn and weathered. But yeah. Well, we'll have a quick look around. Quite catch the name of the church. Is it St. Jude's? I think it was St. Jude's. I'll have a look on the way out. It's quite busy. We'll have a look over here. There's Greek Orthodox, the Greek Orthodox Church of St. Andrew. Yeah, so it's a Greek Orthodox Church there, which is quite strange in a village this small, I have to say, but quite nice at the same time. We'll have a look around there. Thank you. great stonework in it, it has to be said. And these old bike racks, they must date back to the 50s, these. These concrete ones. I'd like to know how long they've been there. Hello there. Yep. Quite impressive. There's no date that I can see in the brickwork, but there was on that one at the front. So it was 150 years. This would probably be a lot older, but it's got the old cast iron pipe work. It's got 1991 up there. That lead work would have been done. Actually rusted away to virtually nothing now. Still there. Well, this is new, so we'll have a look here. Lest we forget, the First World War. Village Sons remembered. 40 Village Sons. Yeah, nice to see. Right, anyway, we shall have a walk up through the town. So, St Jude's United Church. The actual shops there got a date on them, 1865 or 1868. So quite old. So we've got the Holly Tree pub there, nice little old pub. We'll coming to the end of the high street, so we're going to go back down again and take one of these little side roads and have a look. Some of the residential parts of Englefield Green. So we'll just get up to here and we'll cross over. Let's check the traffic. Yep, all clear. A few little restaurants, a couple of pubs, as you would expect in a small village. Pretty quiet on a Sunday. Now it's a Sunday, kind of middle of February, or late February really. It's quite cold, currently about 6 degrees centigrade. Quite chilly, windy, but no rain or snow. So yeah, quite good conditions for a little walk about. We'll walk down this road here and have a look. Stonemasons cottages. 1996. Okay, you've got a little electric vehicle charging points there. Not many vehicles in there though. The Armstrong gun. Must be an Arsenal pub. Italian street food. So you've got some period properties, Victorian, and then you've got these ones that are new builds designed to look Victorian. Thank you. go have a look at this church here. It's quite unusual, the windows. Plaques mean ARF SS. Right, we're in the sort of residential part of it, the social hall. It's quite a small village, it looks like one of the villages that would be pretty much closed up on a Sunday. I mean, things are open, but it is very quiet, it has to be said, which is good on a Sunday, nice and quiet. We'll have a look down here, residential road. Englefield Green Constitutional Club, carved into the brickwork. You see that up there? Very good. Do a lot of bit of decorative brickwork. And these date back to 1899, hillside. Over here, the Jurgen Centre. It looks Greek Orthodox as well, like that was in that cemetery. Let's take a closer look. Just got that design that when you're abroad you sort of see them. But Jurgen obviously is sort of German, so I'm not quite sure. This calls for some investigation. Lovely building, though. Parish of St. Cuthbert. Assumption of Our Lady. Very impressive. I like the downpipes, a little decorative bit around the side, look like little flowers. Can't see any description explaining what it is though. We'll have a look at the front. Wonderful bit of brickwork there. The stained glass window as well. Doesn't appear to be open, whatever it is. Church of Assumption. Right. Got to stand back and take that in. That is a great, great looking building. Mixture of the old and the new there. Love to know when that was built. I'm sure I'll find out, or someone will let me know. So you've got that lovely building, and then you've got the telephone mast there in the background, but it is hidden in the trees, so it's not too much of an eyesore. Well, surprising what you see when you walk off the beaten track. Right, we've got a pub down here called the Happy Man. All these houses have got dates on them as well, and I do like a date. 1892, Headley Cottages, 1897. Looks quite busy. Quite a few happy people by the look of it. Can't believe how quiet it is. It's like a sleepy Sunday you would have got 50 years ago, before everything becomes 7 days a week. Someone's been taking pot shots with eggs on that wall. Sure, this is the dead end up here. Double check with my phone if I can get out this way. Looks like I can. Okay, thanks. Hope Lodge. Ah, there's the Armstrong gun. We've come full circle. Lovely and quiet. Okay, we'll probably end the walk there because we've done gone full circle. So that's a little mini tour of Englefield Green. I don't know the areas very well, so I'm not sure if I've missed any bits of importance. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed the walk. I certainly did. And if you did, maybe you'd consider liking and subscribing. And I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.